The Primaris Redemptor Dreadnought is a huge and heavily armoured walking tomb for a mortally wounded Space Marine hero. Interred within, he's able to continue fighting on, bringing death to the enemies of the Emperor with heavy firepower. In this video, we're going to show you how to paint the Primaris Redemptor Dreadnought in the colour scheme of the Ultramarines. However, by swapping out the colours that we're going to use for the armour for colours of your choosing, you can easily paint it to any chapter that you want by following along with the same methods. So without further ado, let's get started. The first step of painting the Redemptor Dreadnought is to undercoat it, and I've chosen to undercoat it with McCrag Blue Spray, because not only will this prime the miniature, but also it base coats all the blue armour in one go. Now if you wanted to do this by hand, you could undercoat with Chaos Black first of all, and then paint in all the panels using McCrag Blue paint, but if you do so, just be sure to focus on all those blue panels, because, well, the blue armour is what we're going to focus on doing first. Now the next step is going to be apply a shade to it, and it's going to be Nuln Oil. Now as always, remember to shake all your paints before you use each colour, and what we're looking to do here is apply it as what we call a recess shade. So the ideal brush for this is a small layer brush. What you want to do is just get some of this paint and put it onto your palette like this, because doing so allows you to control exactly how much paint you have loaded on your brush at once. You don't need very much really, you just want a good tip on the bristles. And when you're ready, what you're looking to do is look carefully on all the blue armour parts for any recess details. So for example, we've got one running around here. And what you do is just paint that shade directly into that recessed area like that to give a bit more definition to the armour. Whilst you're doing this, be sure to catch all the rivets as well, but remember this is only for the parts that are going to be blue. Once you've finished applying that shade, you're then ready to move on to start to highlight all that blue armour. And for this, we're going to start out with Kronos Blue, which is a dry paint. And to use this paint, what you need to do is dry brush it onto your miniature. Now to dry brush, you need a, well, dry brush, and this is a small dry brush, this one. And what you do is just get a small amount of this paint loaded on the end of the brush, and then get some tissue or some cardboard, something like that. And just use this to start working the paint into the bristles like this, and also getting rid of the excess paint. You want to make sure there's not much paint left on your brush before you start to apply it, because you want to gradually build the colour up. So once you've done that, you see there's not much left on there. What you do is just start looking for all the sharper edges on the armour of your Dreadnought. So a great example is across the front here. And what you do is just lightly start flicking your brush back and forth like this, so the paint starts to catch on all the edges of your armour. So what you need to do now is just carry on doing this all the way around all your blue armour panels. I've finished applying that dry brush now, and you can see it's helping all those blue panels stand out just a bit more. And what we're going to do now is apply a second dry brush to really bring them out just a little bit further. To do this, we're going to use Ethereum Blue this time. The technique is much the same as before. Still using a small dry brush, what you want to do is just get a little bit of this paint on your brush, and then get some tissue, and use the tissue to work the paint in amongst the bristles like this. Now the only real difference here is that we're going to be just a little bit more selective about where exactly we apply this. What you're looking to do is to look for any sharp corners of things and paint it in those sort of areas. So a great example would be these kind of parts just down here. I'm just going to lightly dry brush these points here, just to make them a little bit lighter and stand out a little bit more. So now all you just need to do is carry on going around all your blue armour, just picking out parts like this. With that dry brush applied, we're now ready to move on to the next detail, which is to start painting in some of the metallic details. Now for this, the first colour we need is Lead Belcher. This is a base paint which we're going to apply using a medium base brush, though it's a good idea to have a small base brush on hand because you will need it for some of the finer details here. And what you want to do is just put some of this paint onto your palette like this, because doing so allows you to add a small amount of water to the mix. You don't need loads, but this just helps the paint go a little bit further and dry smoother as well, and it gives you more control over it. Make sure you don't have too much paint loaded onto your brush, and when you're ready, you just need to start painting in all the parts that you want to be silver. So I'm going to start at this part just down here, and with this colour, just be as neat as you can as you paint around all those blue details. Once you've base coated all those silver details, you're now ready to shade them using Nuln Oil once more, only this time the application is going to be a little bit different. I'm going to start out with a medium shade brush, but it's a good idea to have a medium layer brush on hand as well, because you will need it for some smaller details. And what you want to do is, like before, use your palette just to get a little puddle of it here. But what you want to do is paint it this time over, completely over the silver parts that you've done. So make sure you've not overloaded your brush. I'm going to start on the leg just down here. What I'm looking to do is to paint it all over silver parts like this, just being as neat as possible whenever I get close to the blue armour. Once the shade's completely dry, you might want to make some of these silver parts darker. And if you do, it's just a case of applying a second coat of Nuln Oil to these parts. And a great example would be these joints around here. And this time, I'm going to be applying it using a medium layer brush. That second coat of Norn oil is now dry, and we have another optional stage now, because if you want to, you can add some more variety to all these silver parts and break them up a little bit. For this, what you need is Cycorax bronze, and this we're going to be applying using a medium layer brush. And there's no right or wrong place here to apply this paint, really just using it, just spacing it around the miniatures to, as I say, break up that silver a little bit. Now, as before, you want to use your palette to get that paint thinned down so it's nice and smooth and it's quite transparent. You can see this one. Once you've got it ready, all you've got to do is start looking around for some details you can pick out with it. A great example would be this round part we've got here on the ammo drum, so I'm just going to paint this completely with this colour. You can see I've now picked out a few details with Cycorax bronze. We've got some down there in the cannon, and we've got some on the back as well, and even on the power fist arm. And with those painted in, we're now ready to shade them too. And for this, we need Seraphim Sepia. Now this I'm going to be applying with my medium layer brush because we want more control with this color, but still use your palettes to get the paint ready. And once you've got some there loaded on your brush, what you want to do is just start painting this directly over all these bronze details. And now that shade's dry, we're ready to highlight both the silver and the bronze at the same time using another dry paint. This one's going to be Necron Compound, and we need to dry brush it on once more. So back to the small dry brush for this, and like when we were dry brushing blues earlier, just want to get a little bit of this paint on the end of your brush, then get some tissue and use that to work that paint into the bristles and also to get rid of the excess as well. And once you've got rid of most of it, you're ready to start applying it to your miniature, but really carefully this time because you've got to apply it in amongst all that blue armour. So a great example is just down here. I'm just going to angle the brush so I'm using the narrow side of it and just lightly run across here to heart those details whilst also avoiding all that blue. And now that we've finished dry brushing those details, we've finished a lot of the metallic parts. We still have the gold details to do yet, but don't worry about those because we are going to come back to them. Because now we need to paint in all the black details. Now for this, we're going to start out with a base coat of Abaddon Black, and then we're going to highlight all these parts using Eshin Grey. But to begin with that base coat of Abaddon Black, I'm going to start out with my medium base brush, but I recommend having a small base brush or even a small layer brush on hand because you will need it for some of the smaller details. Now as always, make sure to thin your paint down so it's nice and smooth. We want it to be at about that kind of consistency before you start to apply it. And also make sure you haven't overloaded your brush so you've got lots of control over where you're applying the colour. And when you're ready, it's entirely up to you which parts you paint in black. Now I'm going to start with a casing here on our cannon, but this is just an example of the kind of detail you can paint. If you want some ideas, then just check out the box artwork and that'll show you some great places to paint black. Once you've finished blocking in the Abaddon Black, you're now ready to highlight it using Eshin Grey, and we're going to do an edge highlight here. To do that, what you do is use a small airbrush, angle it about 45 degrees against the detail you want to highlight, then just run it along lightly along that edge like that. And this way, you get a neat straight line really quickly. And also be sure to pick out all the rivets with a dot of Eshin Grey as you go through this step. And there we are, that's all the black details completed, and now we're ready to go back to the metallics and finish off those parts with the gold. So for this, we're going to start out with a base coat of Retributor Armour, which I'm going to be applying with a medium layer brush because it gives excellent control for the kind of details we're painting now. So again, use your palette to get your paint ready, a small amount of water mixed in there so it's running nice and smooth and so it'll apply smoothly. And when you're ready, you're looking to pick out all the more decorative features on the miniature. So a great example is a lot of stuff around the sarcophagus just around here. So you're looking at painting this trim, also the trim around the vision port, but also things like the Aquila we've got down here, and any little skull designs that you can find around the miniature. Once you've finished base coating the gold, you're then ready to move on to shading it. And for this, we're going to use Reichlin Flesh Shade, which has given us a really nice warm gold. We're going to be applying it still using a medium layer brush because you don't want to put on too much here. You do need to keep it under control. So use your palette to help do that. And when you're ready, all you've got to do is paint this directly over all the gold details, and you'll see it runs nicely into all those little recesses there and gives a really nice effect. And once the shade's completely dry, you're then ready to move on to highlighting all the gold details. And for this, you need Liberator Gold and a small layer brush to apply it. And what we're looking to do here is to pick out all those sharper edges and details again. So use your palette to get that paint so it's nice and smooth, so it's easy to apply, and then make sure you haven't overloaded your brush by just using the palette there like that. And then what we're looking to do is to pick out all those sharper edges. So again, you can use your brush by just angling it about 45 degrees and just running along those edges like that to get a nice highlight really quickly. For the wings on the Aquila here, what you do is just to make sure you don't have much paint on your brush and just place the bristles against the wings like this and just run it along to get those highlights on the feathers. And there we are, the gold details are complete, but you can see that that Aquila is atop a Crux Terminatus, which we now need to paint in with grey. And at the same time, we can paint any missiles that your Dreadnought may happen to have as well. For this, we're going to start out with Dawnstone before shading over these details with Norn Oil, and then finally highlighting them with Administratum Grey. But we need to start out with Dawnstone, and I'm going to be using my small layer brush to apply this because these details are all very small. Again, use your palette to get your paint ready so it's nice and thin down, so it will apply really smoothly. And once you've done so, all you've got to do is start base coating this onto those details. And remember, just be really neat as you apply this colour, and you will need two thin coats of it. Next, paint a coat of Norn oil all over these grey details that you've just painted in. And once that shade's completely dry, you're ready to apply a highlight of Administratum Grey with your small layer brush. You just want to follow along all the sharpest edges and details just like this to pick those parts out. For the missiles, that just means all you need is a very small amount just on the very tip of each one. And there we are, that's the grey details complete, and we can start painting in the next detail, which is going to be the lens of the searchlight. Now to do this, we're going to start out by base coating it using a shabty bone, and then we're going to shade over it with Seraphim Sepia to make it a little bit more yellow, but then we're going to go back to a shabty bone to highlight it, but focusing towards the middle of the light. So we need to start out with a shabty bone then, which I'm going to apply with my small layer brush because this detail is very small, so you want lots of control here. So as always, use your palette to get that paint ready, and once you've done so, all you've got to do is start base coating this detail in. Now the detail is this little searchlight we've got just here, so you need to be as neat as you can as you paint this in around those metal bars. Once you've finished that, you're ready to shade over the glass with Seraphim Sepia to make it a bit more yellow. And once the shade's completely dry, you're now ready to reapply a small amount of a shabty bone just towards the middle of the light. With that done, we've now completed painting that searchlight, but you can see on the other side of the sarcophagus we've got some targeting lenses and also one of the little missile pod on the top of it as well. And to do these, we need to start out with a base coat of corn red, and then we're going to shade them using Norn oil. After this, we're ready to start highlighting, first of all with Evos and Scarlet, then a small amount of Uriel yellow, and finally a tiny bit of white scar. But we need to start out with corn red for our base colour, and I'm going to stick to my small layer brush to apply this. And as with a searchlight, it's a very small detail, so you must make sure that your paint's flowing really smoothly and that you've not overloaded your brush either. So once you've got the paint ready, all you've got to do is hold your hands as steadily as possible and just start base coating these details in. And you can see I'm just going to start with this one up here. Once you finish that base coat, you're then ready to shade all over the lens using Norn oil. Once the shade's completely dry, you're ready to begin highlighting using Evos and Scarlet. And what you want to do here is paint a kind of crescent shape in the bottom left-hand side of the lens. So just as neatly as possible, you're looking at this kind of area around here. Then repeat this process, but this time using Uriel Yellow, just focus a little bit more towards the bottom left of the light. And finally, add a dot of white scar in the opposite corner. Now that we've completed painting those lenses, we have a few more small details left to do around the sarcophagus, and these are all cables. Now to do this, we're going to do both red cables and yellow cables, and we're going to start out with the red ones, with a base coat of corn red, followed by a highlight of Evos and Scarlet. But then for the yellow ones, we're going to start out with Avalan Sunset, and then highlight them using a shabty bone. But we need to start out with corn red for the red cables, and I'm going to apply this using a small layer brush because all these details are all pretty small now. So as always, use your palette to get your paint ready, and once you've done so, it's really up to you which cables you paint. Most of them are around sarcophagus, but they are scattered around the miniature elsewhere as well, on the back for example, so you want to do all these in the same sort of way. Now I'm going to start with this cable just here, and as I apply this colour I'm going to be really careful not to go all the way up to the edges, so we still keep that Norn oil that we applied earlier, giving a nice bit of definition around the edge just there. Once you've finished picking out those cables, you're then ready to highlight them using Evos and Scarlet. And for this, what you want to do is just paint a thin line of this colour just along the very top of each one. With that done, we're now ready to base coat in the yellow cables using Avalan Sunset. And like before, you just want to be careful not to go all the way up to the edges so as to keep that darker line from the shade we put on earlier. And then you're ready to highlight the yellow cables with a shabty bone. And again, all you want to do is paint a line just running along the very top of each one. Now, once you've done this, your dreadnought's just about finished and you're ready to apply the transfers. But we're also going to show you some really cool weathering effects as well. So what I'm going to do is, once I've finished applying these highlights, I'll add the transfers, and when we come back, we'll show you some really cool weathering techniques. I've finished painting in the cables and have also applied all the transfers to the miniature as well. And now we're going to show you how to do some really cool weathering effects on your miniature to really give it some character. The first effect we're going to show you is how to chip all that blue paintwork. And to do this, what you need is Skaven Blight Dinge, then you'll need Lead Belcher, and you'll need to apply these paints by using a little bit of old sponge, which is what I've got just here. And what we do is use this like a brush. You just get a small amount of the paint on the end of the sponge there like that, and then use your palette to gauge exactly how much you got on there. You don't want to be applying loads at once, so I'm just going to use the palette to get rid of the excess paint there like that. And as you can see, as I do that, it's getting lighter and lighter on the palette, and we're getting more of a speckled effect. And that's perfect for what we need here, because what you do is start looking for corners and things on the armour and just start dabbing this on them like that. And what you'll see happen is a really random effect of this darker colour appearing that gives a really cool natural chipped effect on the armour there like that. So what you want to do now is start going around all the edges of your armour doing this. You can do as much as you like, but I recommend you don't get carried away with it. When you're weathering, often it's the case that less is more. Once you're happy with the amount of chipping, it's time to repeat the process with Lead Belcher this time. The only difference really here is to be just a little bit lighter than you were than with the previous colour. Now that we've finished chipping all that paintwork, we're ready for the next weathering effect, which is to add some residue on the exhausts on the back. And for this, all you need is a Baden Black and a small dry brush. And what we're going to do is stipple this on. To do this, it's much like dry brushing. All you do is get a little bit of the paint and use some tissue to work it in amongst the bristles like this. But when you apply it, rather than running the brush back and forth over the detail, what you want to do is stab it onto it in one direction. So I'm going to start here and just start applying it downwards like this, and you'll see that black just gradually starts to build up. And now that those exhausts are done, we've got one more weathering effect left to add, and that's to add some residue of dirt in the recesses. And for this, all you need is Steel Legion Drab, and I'm going to be applying it with a small layer brush. And what you want to do here is just get some of the paint, put it onto your palette, and then add a lot of water to it so you get a very thin paint. You want it to be kind of like that before you start to apply it. There we go, and then make sure you don't put on too much at once. What you're looking to do is to paint this into some, but not all of the recesses. And a great example of that will be just along the top here. All I'm going to do is just run a small amount of this colour into that area there like that. And if you want to, you can even paint it around some of the rivets. For example, this one just here, paint it around like that, and then you can even draw some of it downwards to give the effect of rainwater. And once you've done this, your miniature is ready to be based, and as always, I recommend you base it in the same way as the rest of your army. And with the base fully painted, this Primaris Redemptor Dreadnought is ready to stride forth onto the battlefield to bring death and destruction to the enemies of the Imperium. So when you're painting your Dreadnought, remember it's a good idea to start out with that main armour colour first, because then you can dry brush it to highlight it and not worry about getting any of that dry brush colour onto other details. Then as you start to paint in those other details, remember to be as neat as you can, especially with all that silver when you're painting in the skeleton of the model. And finally, if you decide to add any weathering to your model, just remember to take your time and build it up gradually. Don't put on too much. It's much easier to add more than it is to take some away. So we really hope you've enjoyed this video on painting the Primaris Redemptor Dreadnought, and remember, by following along the method, you can paint yours for any Space Marine chapter you want to. You just need to change out the armour colours. So we hope you enjoyed this video, and we'll see you again soon.